We want to determine the antiderivative of x to the fifth with respects to x. Or we want to evaluate this indefinite integral, which means we want to determine a function or a family of functions that has a derivative of x to the fifth. Let's take a look at this notation down here just for a moment. Here's some nice review of some vocabulary. But the main idea here is to evaluate an indefinite integral or to determine an antiderivative for little f of x. We want to determine a function that if we find the derivative of that function, it will be equal to the integrand. So the derivative of big F of x plus c is our antiderivative, and its derivative is equal to little f of x, or the integrand. And just like we had formulas to determine derivatives of functions, we will now have a set of formulas to find antiderivatives. The first one is the power rule of integration given here. The antiderivative of x to the nth with respect to x is equal to x to the power of n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus a constant c. Since the derivative of a constant is 0, this plus c represents any possible constant. That's the reason why when we find an antiderivative, we're actually finding a family of functions because c could be any constant. So to find the antiderivative of x to the fifth, we need to recognize that n is equal to 5. So applying our formula, our antiderivative will be x to the sixth, n plus 1, divided by 6, which is also n plus 1, plus any constant c. Or if we wanted to, we could write this as 1 sixth x to the sixth plus c. And again, the main idea here is that if we differentiate this function or family of functions, we should get x to the fifth. So let's go ahead and check that. So the derivative of 1 sixth x to the sixth plus c would be 1 sixth times the derivative of x to the sixth, which would be 6 x to the fifth. Then the derivative of a constant would be 0. So notice if we put this 6 over 1, this simplifies nicely, and we're left with x to the fifth, which verifies that we found the antiderivative correctly. Let's take a look at another example. To determine the antiderivative of 3 with respect to x, we want a function or family of functions that has a derivative of 3. There is a special formula here which tells us that the indefinite integral or the antiderivative of k with respect to x is equal to kx plus c. So applying this formula, the antiderivative of 3 with respect to x would be 3x plus c. Now we could also use the power rule to find this antiderivative. We could think of this as the indefinite integral of 3x to the 0 with respect to x. X to the 0 is equal to 1, so this is still equal to 3, but now we could apply the power rule as we did on the previous slide if we wanted to. So we'd add 1 to the exponent on x and then divide by that new exponent. So we'd have 3 times x to the, well, 0 plus 1 would be 1 divided by 1 plus a constant. This would still be 3x plus c. And this one's pretty easy to check to see. The derivative of 3x plus c would be equal to 3, which does verify our antiderivative. We'll take a look at several more examples of antiderivatives in the next video. I hope this was helpful.